Arts in Motion, in partnership with Rolex.
The sitar is probably the most recognizable, or one of the most recognizable, of the Indian classical musical instruments. It's a very technically challenging, very beautiful instrument. I think some instruments like the piano, for example, you can play it at any level as a complete beginner or as a master. The sitar is one of those instruments where you have to learn to produce the sound first. And it's also quite painful, like it's got very thin strings because we bend into them. So kids are quite daunted by that beginning chapter with the sitar, that it can be quite painful, quite difficult. And it can take easily a year or more to start to produce a sound that's pleasant. Career, when I started making what people call crossover music, you know, there was a little bit of pushback around what I was doing. And similarly, my father before me, you know, had a lot of pushback earlier in his career when he was doing what he was doing. But I've always taken great faith in the fact that our quote unquote traditional music, our classical music, has always been an oral tradition. And what that means is it's been evolving and growing generationally with every time that it's passed on, it assimilates a little bit of the people that are passing it on in that generation. I tend to just know, I'm like, that person, that sound, I need it. It's quite similar to romantic attraction, but just in a musical form. It's just this feeling that, wow, I want to connect with that. I want to know more of that. And that's never steered me wrong so far. I think you can have faith in your own intuition when you've seen it work in the past. So because I had one experience where I wanted to work with someone and that worked out, then the next time I felt that way about someone, I trusted it. And then the next time it was a bit more wacky of an idea, or even more of a different tradition or different style or a different genre. But each time it works, it makes it easier for me to trust that. Mindful of range in music when I'm making an album or when I'm designing a show. So I might start with an initial impulse that wasn't really thought out. Maybe I first wrote some melodies based on pain. But then once those have come out and breathed, then I think more consciously, you know, I've written some songs that are maybe really heartbreaking or really sad. What do I want to leave people with at the end of that? And I usually turn that around, and it's about, what do I need as a human? You know, if I've put out some pain, I then need to find some hope. Because otherwise, it's a very dystopian, awful place to be left in.